name is Kim Fowler, and I am the education manager here at Trees for Tomorrow. We were practicing RT rescues today, which is just a fancy way of saying how do you right a canoe when it flips in the middle of a lake in deep water where you can't really easily stand up. It's really important for us as a staff to practice RT rescues because you never know what's going to happen out on the lake with our participants. Some people just don't have a naturally good balance. Sometimes we have students who like to horse around and get a little too rough. So it's important to be able to rescue those people, even though they always wear a PFD, even though our staff is lifeguard certified. We need to make sure that we're giving our participants the best experience, and that includes getting back in the boat. And even when you practice it and you know what you're doing, as our staff do, I think everyone on staff has done a T rescue, it's important to practice every year so that when that happens, you just go into action mode and you know what you to do. The first thing that happens during a T rescue is obviously a boat flips over. The rescue boat will pull up so that it forms a right angle with the capsized vessel, and then what's going to happen is the two canoes are going to form a T like this, and the people who were in the capsized canoe, those in need of rescue, are going to swim over to the end. They're going to push down to pop the seal on the overturned canoe, and while they're pushing down, the rescuers are going to pull up on the canoe, and that releases that seal. The people in the water are going to push their canoe so that it is straddling the rescue boat, so it forms almost like a lowercase T. The people in the rescue boat are then going to both shift to the middle, so they're kneeling in the bottom of their canoe, and they're going to work together to flip the canoe so that it's right side up. And then, once the canoe is right side up, they'll push the canoe to one side of the vessel and pull it around so the two boats are parallel. And then that will allow the participants who are in the water to get back into the canoe through a variety of means. They can belly crawl back into the boat. They can almost bob like a cork and then push their legs up and straddle the canoe and use their leg muscles. Or our educator Todd constructed a really nifty makeshift ladder out of PVC piping and really heavy duty rope. Almost like a step ladder you'd find on the edge of a pool, so that participants are able to climb their way up really easily. So that's really helpful, especially for some of our adult participants, some of our Road Scholar participants, and then some of our other participants who have mobility problems but can still canoe, that it makes it very accessible for everyone in the water.
My name is Beth. I'm an educator at Trees for Tomorrow. So I was partaking in the tea rescues today, and this is the ladder that Todd made to help people get into canoes. Not all of us have the best upper body strength, so to assist people climbing into the canoes, we can lay this over the canoe and hook it onto the rescuer's canoe and hold it in place. The other end hangs in the water and they can kind of climb up and then kind of belly crawl and kind of give a little shimmy.